Hey, what's up, darlings? Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So, since many of my subscribers really like Winx Club, I decided to make the video on some other magic related games. So the games are from a group called L'Assemblée, but the group recently got locked. I don't know why, but yeah, I will show the games to you guys and I hope y'all enjoy. So the first game I'm gonna show you guys is called Enchantment RP. So this game is basically a roleplay game, and it's for people that really like magic and fairies. So you can turn into a fairy or a siren, and I will show you guys the way to get to the siren pool and the fairy pool, and how to transform into one on mobile or on PCs. So when you spawn into the game, you will spawn either here or a little further over here. So what you're gonna do, you're just gonna walk or run. If you wanna run, just hold shift, and it's gonna be this run and not your regular animation. So then you're gonna be here, so go up here all the way till you see these two tunnels. So this side is from the siren pool, I'll show you guys now. So you fall through here, and then you run over here, and this is the siren pool. So at midnight, this pool will glow red, and it will have like red bubbles. So that's when you jump into the pool and become a siren. So now I will show y'all the fairy pool. So it's a little bit harder to go up there, but I will show it. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna take this tunnel and not this one. So you're gonna go through this one, and you're gonna continue running or walking up till you get here. So you see the siren pool over here and this waterfall. So what you're gonna do, you're just gonna go left, just keep jumping on the left side till you see this, where you can't go forward anymore. Then you're gonna turn left, but be careful because many people fall here. You're gonna climb up these rocks, just keep climbing till you see this, and just go over here, and just watch out that you don't fall here, because then you will fall all the way down to the siren pool. So when you come here, and this will be the fairy pool. So I will wait for you guys till it's midnight so I can show you guys how to be both species, siren and fairy. Okay, so as you guys can see, the pool is now glowing blue, and this is the fairy pool. So you're gonna go into this, and then this fairy icon will appear here. So you're just gonna get out of the pool, and then if you're on PC, to transform into a fairy, you have to press the keybind F. So as you can see, I'm now a fairy, and you just double press a space, and then you can fly around the map, and you can hold shift to go faster. But if you're on mobile or iPad or tablet or whatever, you will just have to press this glowing icon over here, and then you will transform back. But if you want to transform into a fairy, you just press the glowing button again, and then you will transform into a fairy. So as you guys can see, I have pink wings, they're like light pink. So if you buy the fairy customization game pass, you can have colorful wings, and you can like customize your aura lights and your wings. So I'll show that now. So you press this fairy over here, and then go to customize. You can just customize your wing color and your light color. So as you can see, I just made them a darker shade. You can also make them red if that's what you're wishing for. I honestly think white wings really match my outfit, so I'm just gonna do white with a pink light. You can also customize your ears by going to the fairy and going to change, and then you can choose your wings. You can do powdery, and then you will get those wings. Well, in my opinion, I don't really like them. I really like the delicate ones. They're just more fairy much. And you can also change your ears to powdery or delicate. So yeah, that's basically everything you can do as a fairy. You sadly cannot do spells, but I will show the spells in the next game I'm gonna show. But first, I'm gonna wait till it's midnight to show you guys how to be a siren. So guys, as you can see, the siren pool is now glowing red, so I'm gonna jump into it. And as you can see, I just turned into a siren, so you just press F, and you will have your tail, and you will have like this top made of shells, and you will also get those ears. So as a siren, you have a few customization options. So the first one is gonna be your tail. So you have your tail, if you're gonna press depths, you will have this tail. and Surface will be this tail, and Kaplan will be this tail. I honestly like Kaplan the most, so I'm just gonna hold this one. You can also change your top to custom shirts, so you can wear your own shirt. You also have shells, you can put shells. You have Kaplan, Depths. I think those are like all the same almost, like Surface. Yeah, those are just a little bit smaller, and Depths. And the ears, we have Surface ears. Oh, those are actually really pretty. Okay, then Depths. Those look kind of weird to be honest, but yeah. And then Kaplan, those are like the basic ones you get. So yeah, you can clearly see that Sirens have more customization options than Fairies. But I honestly just like Fairies most, because you can like fly around the map and it's just good transport. But Sirens are a little bit slow on land and you just, yeah, turn into this and you're very slow. But you are very, very fast in water, so I'll just show you guys now. So I'm gonna go into the water and turn into a Siren. And as you can see, I am like a lot faster underwater than on land, and if you press shift you go even faster, and it's pretty awesome to be a Siren. Like, they made it very realistic to be honest, and it's really, really cool. And I want to say something real quick. So if you are already turned into a Siren or a Fairy, and if you go into the other species pool, you will not turn into the other creature. So if you're a Fairy and you go into the Siren pool, you will not turn into a Siren and you will not die or something. You would just stay a Fairy. And something else is, if you reset as a Fairy or Siren, you're not gonna turn into a human, you will just stay what you were before resetting. So another thing is that you can pick people up when they are fainted. So as you can see, I picked this Siren up, she was fainted under the floor, and you can pick people up, and as a Fairy, you can just fly and bring them anywhere, but as a Siren, you can't really do anything. So as you can see, her health just came back, and I think she's conscious now. And if you want to know how to faint, you just press this settings button over here, and you can have an RP name, and here is the button of feigning. So you press faint and you will faint, and people can like pick you up if they want to. So I'm just gonna see if someone's gonna pick me up. No, the disrespect. Okay, so the second game I'm gonna show you guys is called Sorcery. So in this game you can do spells and hit people and kill people. So I will first just go through the inventory. So first we have a flashlight, it's pretty useless, it's only useful in the dark. Then we have a phone, it's an Apple iPhone, so you can just call with it if you want to, just RP. And this is my favorite, we have an umbrella. If it's raining, you can just walk here as a baddie, no one can stop you, get your bag. And then we have a book, so you can also just pretend you're reading if you're trying to RP. Then we have a fist, and this actually deals damage to people if you hit them with this. So yeah, and then we have a rose. If you click on your screen, the rose will turn into a different color. So it has multiple colors like pink, gray, blue. And so this is a place where people mostly hang out. This is Freddy's bar. And you can just sit here and just like pretend like to order a drink, like RP, and do different spells. So I will now go over the spells. So the first one is a transmutation or a teleportation. On PC you're able to do this when pressing Q, so it will look like this. So I'm pressing Q and I want to go there, and you just teleport over here. And on mobile, I think you will have to say transmutation, and then you will be able to teleport, but I don't know why it isn't working. So the second spell I'm going to be showing is a bone break spell, and in order to do this, you have to type Osox Kresa in your chat, and then you will be able to break someone's bones. As you can see, I just broke his neck. So the third spell I'm going to show is a healing spell. So you have to type Vitere in the chat and press on yourself, and you will heal yourself. So as you can see, my health bar just went all the way up because the spell helped me heal. The fourth spell is going to be an immobilization spell. That's basically just freezing someone. So I'm going to go and find a target. So the spell that you're going to use to immobilize someone is going to be Immogears, I think that's how you spell it. So you're going to press someone and you will do that animation. And as you can see, I just froze them. They can't move anymore. There is no freezing animation, but they just stand still for a while and they will just stay there. So yeah, that's that spell. The fifth spell I'm going to be showing is a speed spell. So you will be able to run really fast. So you have to type Rapiers, and you will do that weird animation, and then you will be able to run really fast through the map if you're not willing to teleport. So there is a last spell that you can do. It's a sacrificeation spell, but you sacrifice yourself. Just it's pretty useless, it doesn't hurt anyone else, but it's glitched right now, so it doesn't work, so I'm not gonna showcase it, but I'm just gonna put the spell here so y'all just know what the spell is, just in case it comes back. But you can find all the spells in their description of the game, so that's no problem. So now let's move on to the last game I'll show you guys. So the last game I'm going to show you guys is called Obscurate, and it's a vampire game. The main reason why this game will have a lot of glitches is because it just got released and it's still in beta, so y'all gonna expect some glitches and bugs and things not working properly. So I'm just gonna show you guys how to transform. So on PC you need to press T to transform, and then you will have this face and you will get this animation, and you will be able to run really fast. So as you can see, I'm letting this trail behind me. My apologies if y'all can see me good, but it's like night right now in the game. So something you really need to watch out for is if you are transforming into a vampire when it's day and the sun is shining, you need to wear this ring before transforming, because otherwise your health bar will just go down and you will just die, because vampires can't go into the sun. So this ring just protects you from the sunshine so you don't die. So another thing you have is fist. This was also a thing in the previous game I showed you guys, so you can also just hurt people with this. And the last thing you have is a knife, and I think this is very, very cool. So you can just stab people with this and they will lose health and then they will die. Like they will come back, but like you can just carry them because they got fainted. And you can also just press this button over here and do a RP name and faint, and also just press sit if you want to sit, but it's really weird. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and if you did, make sure to like, subscribe to my channel, and go follow me on Roblox. I will link my channel down below, and make sure to check out the other videos if you like this one, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye darlings.